The kind of world that we are passing through right now, it is really very important to remember those figures and like how actually certain different approaches are kind of were there towards like the other in the societies, and how these projects were successful and it really helped generations to build a different sense of being for themselves, and also in terms of you know, understanding oneself as a different citizen. It is really, really very important like to go over these histories, because of course nomadic existences I think has been considered as a danger to the normative order of the societies for in Europe, like for a really long time, and it is also like used also as a fuel for I would say like right wing nationalistic discourses also, because they can be easily identified as like the outsider enemy because they refuse to settle in that order that that the capitalist system asks them to, and they have a very different other relationship to the world than the normative education also like kind of sets on demand. And I think like most of the people, majority of the people don't know like how these actually regulations, as you said, like kind of continued until very recently. Yeah. These are very, very present still, and these are not really like clearly discussed, while of course at the same time there are many different gestures and many important like kind of, let's say, cultural collaborations are happening more. Also in Venice Biennial there was also the Roma Pavilion at some stage, I remember. I think like art is certainly one of the most important mediums like to also dissipate and like to circulate the untouched or like kind of pushed back, elbowed back information, which is part of like the certain reactions that kind of we have, why certain people are so confident in defending their, you know, bigotry, I would say, because they feel secure, because and there are certain protections also by the state systems. Such regulations against the people, also Roma, the people of the world, they are the people of Europe. As well, maybe also like the whole Europe that they, you know, they own in a certain way.
Yeah, absolutely,
More than anybody else. And like this, somehow also I think all of this background, like continuous regulations and prejudices also now appear, you know, in the border, in the idea of border and sovereignty and like kind of nationalism kind of coming to certain savior of like the state structures right now in Europe, rather than seeing themselves, you know, in a more like a kind of a collaborative alliance. Mm-hmm.